Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to design and create the look of a vintage matchbook cover. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, we'll create our background and text design, and in part two, we'll add retro graphic elements to complete it. I provided a free Photoshop template so you can follow along. Its link is located in my video's description or project files. The layers include a smart object of the matchbook cover, a paper texture overlay, and a patterned background. If you want to change the pattern, double-click it to open the pattern fill window and experiment with the pattern presets until you find one you like. I'm using the Nature Patterns preset and the Blue Daisies pattern, which at this size looks like a retro Formica countertop. Next, we'll add text to our cover, but first, make the matchbook layer active. Our text will be placed above it. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a retro font. I'm using Master of Break Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll use a size of 170 points, but feel free to adjust it based on the amount of characters in your text. Click the color box to open the color picker. Pick a color you like for your main text. I'm using a bright red, but because this particular color is so vibrant, I'll reduce its saturation to 90% since colors on vintage matchbook covers lose their color vibrancy over time. Click on your document and type out your text. To adjust the space between two characters, click between those characters and press and hold Alt or Option as you press the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. To adjust the space between the lines of text, highlight your bottom line and click this icon to open the character panel. If you don't see this icon, go to Window and Character. Drag the baseline shift icon to the left or right until your lines of text are spaced to your liking. To slide one of your lines over, click the left of the first character and, as before, press and hold Alt or Option as you press the left or right arrow key. Continue to finesse it until you're happy with its spacing. To reposition your entire text, open your Move tool and move it. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Then press Enter or Return. Make a copy of your text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Make the original text layer active and click the FX icon. Click Drop Shadow. Click the color box and pick 20% gray. Make sure global light is checked, and for the angle, type in 138 degrees. The distance is 39 pixels, and click OK. Click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. This will allow us to add effects to our text, including its drop shadow. Control-click or Command-click the large T next to the copy to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. Expand the selection by 10 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Shift-click the text copy to make it active as well and convert the two text layers into one smart object. To add another smaller line of text, open your Type tool and either use the same font or pick another. I'll make its size 60 points, but again, feel free to adjust its size. If you want to pick a different color for your new line of text, click the color box and pick another color. If you pick black, your text will look better if its brightness is increased 10 to 20%. Click on your cover and type out your text. To reposition it as before, open your Move tool and move it. Shift-click your main text to make it active as well, and again, convert all the text into one smart object. To angle your text, open your Transform tool, go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it to an angle you like. To reposition it, just move it. Then press Enter or Return. If you're done adding text, we can close the character panel. Next, we'll add effects to make it look as if it was actually printed on the cover. Go to Filter, Pixelate, and Color Halftone. Keep the default screen angles and make the maximum radius 10 pixels. Next, we'll add a slight blur to the text because the type of inexpensive paper that vintage matchbook covers were manufactured with would have resulted in a slightly blurry image. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels. Lastly, we'll make the edges slightly irregular because the surface feel of the paper, also known as tooth of the paper, would have been fairly rough, giving our image subtle, feathery, irregular edges. Go back to Filter, Distort, and Ripple. Make the amount 35 to 40% and the size large. In part 2, we'll finish our vintage matchbook cover with retro graphic elements. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.